Most of you will know Patrick O'Flynn. He's an MEP for the East of England, but he was previously chief political commentator for the Daily Express. And it was thanks to him, I believe, that the Daily Express was the first British newspaper to come out for out. So I'll hand over to Patrick to tell you all about Voices for Britain. Good morning, Patrick.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming along. When I was a political journalist, I always limited my own literary output to the 1,000-word essay, and I was always hugely admiring of fellow columnists who found the time and indeed the creativity to become fully fledged authors. And in that sentiment was the genesis for today's events, because we live in an age where I think it's fair to say large segments of the voting public now respond more enthusiastically to cultural commentators and to authors than they do to politicians. And I think that's probably true in respect of male politicians of a certain age and a certain class background. We have some brilliant political performers in the Eurosceptic movement who I personally find very convincing, but I am also aware that there are a large number of people out there that we need to vote for us in the referendum who may respond to other approaches and other voices too. So conscious of the need for the Leave campaign in the upcoming referendum to have the broadest possible appeal to the maximum number of people, I've decided to scout around in search of Eurosceptic voices in the literary and cultural world. And I've been delighted by what I've found. And today we're giving Westminster, I suppose, a literary salon with a political edge. And we're also offering a platform for two of the brightest young voices for Euroscepticism. We have two panels to present to you today. And altogether we have four leading authors, each of whom is also a hugely admired newspaper columnist. And we have two highly rated young thinkers, one from the centre-left in the guise of the Labour Leave group, and one from the centre-right Conservative Woman's blog site. Our authors have as many links overall, I think it's fair to say, to the centre-left in their origins as they do to the centre-right. And in combination, I hope and think, you're going to be offered a wide-ranging, eloquent and well-balanced case for why Britain should leave the EU. I know there are people here from sort of various roles, official and unofficial, in the campaign for Britain to leave the EU, and I'm sure they'll be looking at our speakers with an eye to when the campaign proper really gets going and dominates the agenda. And I too will carry on this mission to bring in people from the literary world, from the cultural world, from non-conventional Eurosceptic backgrounds. There'll be an opportunity for journalists to talk to our contributors at the end, but we're conscious it's a Prime Minister's Questions Day, and so we'll be aiming to have speeches completed by around 7:30 to allow political journalists here to get back, leave our delightful SW1 literary salon, and return to hearing politicians doing Punch and Judy routine PMQs. I'm delighted that my friend Suzanne Evans, herself a brilliant political communicator, has agreed to chair today's event. So now I'll hand over her to introduce the first speaker. Thank you very much.